Now, when we come to the 93rd Psalm, it's a very brief psalm, you will notice here. It's a little psalm that's tucked in here, just 5 verses. And here, the Lord has come to his glorious reign over the earth. And who is it? Jehovah reigneth. That's the Lord Jesus. He's clothed with majesty. Jehovah's clothed. He hath girded himself with strength. This is a psalm that really have meaning when he comes to reign on this earth. And the rebellion and opposition will be broken down and be over with. And all that oppose God has been dethroned on the earth. Listen as you move down in this little psalm here. The floods have lifted up, O Lord. The floods have lifted up their voice. The floods lift up their ways. The flood tide of sin is over now. And Satan, his head has been crushed. And the Lord on high is mightier than the noise of many waters, yea, the mighty waves of the sea. Thy testimonies are very sure. Holiness becometh thine house. Now we come to the 94th Psalm here. And from Psalm 94 to 100, we have another little series of psalms that tell out a consecutive story. And goes from Psalm 94 to Psalm 100. And it's a prophetic section altogether. They are glorious millennial psalms, and they reveal the revelation of the Lord Jesus Christ in his reign down here upon this earth. And it follows that time of Jacob's trouble and all of the trouble that came to man on the earth during that period. It's a glorious picture of the future. Now, in this section, I'm just going to lift out just a few things that are here. And again, you have it as it opens like this. O Lord God, to whom vengeance belongeth, O God, to whom vengeance belongeth, show thyself. Shine forth, as it were. Shine forth, O God. And a great many today saying, oh, if the Lord would only come. Well, he's coming, friends, but he's coming on his schedule, not on my schedule or the schedule of any man down here. Then when he comes, he'll take care of all of these things that he's told you and me to walk in faith, holding his hand today, and he says, vengeance is mine. I will repay, saith the Lord. I'm going to take care of this. This is his coming to straighten out everything on earth. A lot of things to be straightened out. And he's coming in great power and great glory to this earth. Now he says, in the meantime, avenge not yourselves. Trust him. Turn these matters over to him. And he's coming. And again, we have a reference here, verse 8, to the brutish are the stupid. Understand ye stupid among the people. And ye fools, when will ye be wise? And he says here, he who planted the ear, shall he not hear? Now, God's a spirit. He doesn't have an ear like I have, but he hears. And he doesn't have an eye like I have, but God sees. The sinner down here, for some reason, thinks he's getting by with it. God hears, God sees, and he's able to keep a record. And you're coming up for judgment. There are not but two places for your sins. Either your sins are on Christ or they're on you. Now, if they're on Christ, the judgment is passed. Pass from judgment to life. There's a glorious prospect ahead. But my friend, if you haven't come to Christ, you're yet to come up for judgment. And God sees this. And the psalmist can say here in verse 18, when I said, my foot slippeth, thy mercy, O Lord, help me up. David said, I would have slipped up. But God